The good right hand from Pickering. That's a shot that he's finding easier to use. And that was a very good stoppage. All started with a good right hand. There it is, just nicely on the chin. He went down pretty heavily there. Just leant back, got himself bending those knees and got a bit of, you know, good solid punching into there. And that was a good shot.
And Carr's not noted for lacking resilience, is he, either? Or he hasn't been up till now.
He certainly isn't. You know, you wonder if suddenly the legs have started to go from Carr, but you can't take that much away from Pickering.
No.
Good punches that did it.
It's just part of the debate as well, of course. I think Carr did have a big problem making the weight. It has come late, but take nothing at all away from Esham Pickering, who has put together two wins this year, one for the Commonwealth crown, now the British title added to it. So everything's coming up roses for him. All over in round four. Nice lad too.
Holding on more frequently as well. A and he could demoralise them. He's a bitch, can't he, Esham Pickering? If you can't hit the target, it's a terrible worry. And if the target keeps hitting you, it's an even bigger worry. As once again, Pickering goes to work here in great style. And he's got Mayon now, running all over this ring. Cracking right there. Eyes went up to the head. And just remind you, by the way, these two men's records. The challenger, 31 years of age, won 24 straight fights with 10 wins inside the limit. The champion, Esham Pickering, 28 now, with 27 wins, 3 losses and 11 wins inside. Coming at making the second event of his European Super Featherweight crown. And that's the moment when Mayon went running across the ring. And a follow-up there from Pickering, could have put him over. He looks very demoralised now, doesn't he? Almost thought about going down there. Takes a good right. Well, these are good punches now here from Esham Pickering. Uppercuts, hooks of both hands, body and head. And Miguel Mayon is in trouble here. Tries to hang on. Pickering shakes him off. Esham comes back. Oh, well, that's one way of doing it. That's one way of doing it. They've taken a point off Pickering's scorecard for what really is essentially amounts to a very clever move. Oh, he's got it now. A little right hand there. That's all it took. And Mayon on the floor here in round 10. And it looks very shaky. It's all over. So Esham Pickering then retains his European Super Bantamweight crown with a 10th round stoppage win over Miguel Mayon. The Spanish are unhappy, but they've got nothing to complain about.